Hi-ho!
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 It's home from work we go.
Hi-ho!
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 Will there be anything else now?
No, that's all. Thank you, Mr. Bumble. Why, where's Honey tonight?
Say, somebody's in trouble. Excuse me a minute.
Godzilla, King of the Monsters. Incredible Titan of Terror. Wiping out a city of 6 million in a holocaust of flame. Jet flames cannot destroy it. Bombs cannot kill it. All modern weapons.
Replicas of virtually every Los Angeles landmark were constructed with exacting attention to detail. And then, completely destroyed.
Very good start.
A landscape model involves entirely different concerns than a structural model like a starship or space station. With a landscape, building a believable environment is more important than technical precision.
There's more miniatures in this movie than probably any two movies combined. There's cities to build, there's alien craft, alien creatures. It just runs the whole gamut.
In his 33-year career, Pop Day used the latent image process to create hundreds of match shots in more than 45 films. His credits include the 1940 remake of The Thief of Baghdad, 60 Glorious Years, and The Mikado, for which Day created Japanese temples on a London soundstage.
We won because of the wonderful things he does. You ought to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
To match the director's concept for this scene, without actually building a huge and expensive set, the filmmakers resort to what is called a glass painting shot. A California artist paints a background on glass that will later surround the scene in which Alec Guinness appears. A blank spot is left on the glass painting for the live-action scene.
Creating a match shot involves painting a set or location which would be too expensive or even impossible to photograph live. This studio has created spectacular vistas for Cape Fear.
Wherever the attention of the compositionist focus is where we put the most detail, where the actor might be walking. The second, of course, is time. If we don't have much time, we don't have much time, and we have to go for the broader strokes and more impact.
After the painting is complete and photographed, it is edited into the film. If the matte painters have done their work well, movie audiences will never detect that the scene wasn't shot on location. Elements like a miniature train help audiences accept a two-dimensional painting as reality. Another time-honored matte technique involves letting light pass through holes in the painting to simulate city lights. Matte artist Michael Pangrazio is lighting up the city of Salem in this painting for Disney's Hocus Pocus.
Thinking of. All kinds of.
I had to kill Bob Morton because he made a mistake. Now it's time to erase that mistake.
What's this? What's this? There's color everywhere. What's this? There's white things in the air. What's this? I can't believe my eyes. I must be dreaming. Wake up, Jack. This isn't fair. What is this? Haven't you heard?
Remember, there is someone out there for everyone.
I think you're extraordinary.
Why?
I don't know yet. It's just obvious to me.
With the computer controls developed especially for Star Wars, it was possible to film the elements for this sequence with a freedom never before exercised in motion picture production. By controlling the motion of the camera, and by remembering those motions, the computer allows for more complex and visually dynamic photography.
To achieve the airplane's dynamic movement, Bruno relied on motion control technology. The heart of any motion control system is a computer, which can be programmed to relay information to motors that move a prop or a camera.
There were always techniques that required the camera to be locked off, because once you started to move the camera, it would give away the illusion of one person being further away when you're really wanting them to look like they're side by side.
In order to get the camera alive, we started thinking about ways of using motion control in order to doing, you know, what we call moving force perspective shots, using slave motion control bases.
Academy Awards for special effects, and it was T2's use of computer-generated imaging that established a new benchmark for special effects.
So we did a lot, what we call a technique called ray sampling, where we take a patch of geometry and fire it against the two areas that are broken, and it creates a nice smooth fillet in between them.
And he said that Spielberg is coming up with this film, and it's going to be stop motion. Tippett's doing all the work. And would it be possible to add motion blur to the stop motion data? So Mark and I bought it up right away. Why don't we just build the whole damn thing in CG? Oh, no. No, you can't do it.
I immediately stuck up my arm and said, hey, come on, digital dinosaurs. But it was definitely, we had to evolve to that point.
Walt Disney Pictures presents a totally new animated motion picture event.
Star Command, come in. Do you read me?
The story of two toys. Ooh.
There seems to be no sign of intelligent life anywhere.
Hello?
Oh, yeah!
Incoming!
Mayday, mayday. This is Roughneck 2-0.
Commander Tesla, we need retrieval now.
The pipes are coming. Oh, Jesus, fuck! Oh, gummy skin! She's peeling me
what
fucking
stuff?
Skin!
Fuck!
Entering a safety zone. No unauthorized weapons allowed beyond this point. You are now entering a safety zone. No unauthorized weapons allowed beyond this point.
Our first feature, though, is Final Fantasy. You probably heard about this movie if you haven't seen it. It's the first computer-generated feature that attempts to have truly lifelike human characters.
If they knew about these dreams, they'd shut me down.
This is really a new kind of animation.
Andy's physical presence on set became an important part of how Gollum was developed. And so what we wanted to do was to take all that physicality and find a way to capture that and bring it to the digital character of Gollum.
I did not murder him!
Ever simulate anger before?
You have to do what someone asks you. Don't you, Detective Spooner?
How the hell did you know my name?
Don't you? If you love them.
Davey's 100% computer generated. No part of him was actually filmed on set. We had Bill Nighy on set acting, and everything we did built on top of Bill's fantastic performance. But everything you see on the screen is computer generated.
Yeah, it's an optical motion capture system. The big emphasis is real time. What you're seeing on the stage, you're seeing, you know, George is seeing directly on the screens behind us. So he can be, you know, and he's looking at penguins. He can be directing them as if, you know, they're there. He's looking at, you know, penguins on a set.
It's not the stuff that they had done before, which is what we call marker-based. We're now image-based. We got the best animators in the world to take all this data that was coming out of our performance captures, and then we limited their options to things that were value-added, like the ears and the tails. So they took a human performance with no diminishment whatsoever, and then added to it. So when people ask me, you know, sort of what percentage of the actor's performance came through in the final character, I say 110%.
It would have been impossible for us to make this movie a few years ago.
turning what they learned on King Kong to Avatar, what had brought their technology to another level for this movie to make our apes look real.
This is the first live-action film that has its main character as a thoughtful, feeling, self-aware animal.
Whoa, chill. It's just a mask. See? Don't freak out. Right?
We're really acting these parts out. We're shooting a scene like we're shooting a movie, and then they're using this unbelievable technology to transfer what we've done and turn it into a turtle.
Andy, that looks good.